Relationships, they're a big part of being a teenager. When am I going to start dating? When will I ever be in a serious relationship? Will I get married or stay single? Most of you probably have these thoughts going through your mind. Hi, this is Bertie, and I'm here to share a little bit of the female perspective on relationships and dating. I'm going to start with sharing a little bit of my history in dating, and I'm going to talk about my current dating relationship with my husband, and I'm going to leave you with three suggestions to consider when dating. Now, you may think, I'm really old, and when I was dating a long time ago, back in the late 80s and early 90s, but some things still hold true today in 2017. So first, my history. I came to DOC as a freshman, and I was searching frantically for a picture for my freshman year, but fortunately, I couldn't find any. So I started dating someone special, whose name was Mark. And remember this name for later. Not sure you can date as a 14-year-old. When I was a freshman, it was more like going out, was what it was called. So dating consisted of bike rides to each other's house, phone calls. Now remember, we only had a landline, and we had only two phones in our house. So we had one upstairs in my parents' bedroom, and downstairs in the kitchen. And I'm the youngest of six, so I didn't get much phone time. And we did go to the movies one time, I remember that. But this relationship did not last long. I realized that I did not want to be tied down. I was new to the campus, and there were a lot of people I wanted to meet. So sophomore year came, and I felt hard for a senior guy. I consider this my first true love. We dated for over a year, but he left me high and dry when he headed off to college. Thank goodness for good friends who got me through the sadness. But no worries, it was my junior year, and I had plenty of time to date. I even remember when Mr. Reese set me up with one of his basketball players. It is busy with four kids, two jobs, and an active lifestyle. we are blessed. We have been faithful to God and to one another. God has given us a lovely children and an amazing life together. This past August, we celebrated our 25th anniversary. You can go to the next slide. And we still laugh at times thinking of how our life began. So this is from this past year. There we are. Okay, next slide. So that leaves me with three suggestions for successful relationships. These are the ones that hold true for still today. All right, first one. Take your time. Do not rush. I was not looking for a relationship, especially with Mark Murphy, but you will know when it is right. Pray to God for wisdom. Get to know the guy or girl you're interested in. Get to know the family. Spend time together with their friends. Spend time with their church family. Just take your time. Second, foster friendship. Be friends with people of the opposite sex. That way we'll know. That way it will not be so awkward when you start dating. Get to know the people you're interested in. Once you start a friendship, you may realize that, no, I'm not interested in this person in a romantic way. Or, wow, there's a major attraction. I had several good guy friends in high school and college that were just that, friends, and that I feel is okay. But girls, do not be a tease. Do not lead guys on into thinking you want more when you really do not. And this holds true even when you are dating. Do not lose contact with your close friends. Girls, never put a guy in front of your closest friends. Guys, keep your guy friends. You need them for that. It is important to have more than one person in your life. Even today, I have my close girlfriends that help me through the ups and downs in life. And I would never want to be without them. Yes, Mark is my husband and knows everything about me, but I need my girlfriends to meet a different need. And last, trust the process. Have you all heard this term? You know where it comes from? Sixers have used it a lot this year as they are rebuilding their team. We watch a lot of basketball in our house, and my husband often reminds my boys to trust the process. And this holds true in a dating relationship. Relationships evolve. They cannot be forced. You cannot instantly be in a serious relationship. They take time. When it is meant to be, it will happen. Mark and I did not say at the age of 19 that this was the person I was going to marry. But over the time, we realized we wanted to spend the rest of our lives together. Our relationship was affirmed by good sets of parents and friends. Our relationship grew stronger over time. We did not break up, get back together, break up, get back together. So, next slide. In conclusion, I hope you remember today to take your time in relationships, foster friendships, and trust the process. Most of all, ask the Lord for wisdom and guidance in your relationship, and turn to Him with questions.